Hi, I'm Corey. I'm a CPA and subject matter expert in financial accounting. And in this video, we're going to run through everything you need to know about the expense recognition and measurement process. We'll start off with a high-level overview to make sure we understand what expenses are. Next, we'll dive into what it means to recognize and measure an expense in the financial statements. And we'll look at a few examples along the way. We can think of expenses as the money that a company spends while carrying out business activities with the intention of earning revenue. Examples include things like office supplies, utilities, employee wages, and taxes. Each period, all of the company's operating expenses are compiled and recorded on the income statement. We deduct these expenses from the revenue that a company generates to determine the total net income for that period. Understanding how to manage and appropriately account for these expenses is crucial for an organization's profitability. Think about some of your own expenses that you have on a monthly basis. You likely pay for things like rent, cell phone, fuel, and groceries. Online subscriptions to stream shows or gym memberships might also account for some of your monthly expenses. Businesses incur the same types of expenses, and their ability to manage them effectively can mean the difference between success and failure. This is why it's so important that we understand how to account for expenses within the financial statements. Before we go any further, the first step is to understand the concept of expense recognition. Now, it may seem obvious, but the expense recognition principle helps us determine when we're required to recognize an expense on the company's income statement. For the sake of convenience, some smaller companies use the cash basis to record the expenses. This means they recognize the expense in their financial statements as soon as they release the payment. However, most larger organizations that follow generally accepted accounting principles use the accrual basis to record expenses. Under this set of accounting standards, the expense recognition principle states that expenses should be recognized in the same period as the revenues to which they relate. The goal of this principle is to match up the revenue and expenses in the same period on the income statement so that profit is reflected accurately. Let's take a look at an example. A company that sells watches purchased $10,000 worth of merchandise in December from their overseas supplier. It sells the watches to its customers the following month in January for $25,000. Under the expense recognition principle, even though the company spent the $10,000 in the first December month, the expense should not be recorded until the following month when the sale takes place in January. This allows the company to match up the expense with the revenue and accurately reflect the $15,000 of profit from the sale in the January income statement. If the company would have recorded the $10,000 expense in December, since there was no revenue that month to match it up against, they may have shown a loss in the financial statements. This has financial implications for the company, which could result in problems trying to obtain financing from a bank or raise funds from investors. This is why it can be so important for companies to understand this expense recognition principle. Now that we have a good understanding of how to recognize an expense, let's run through a few common misconceptions. We spoke earlier about the goal of matching expenses with the corresponding revenue. However, some expenses are difficult to match up with the timing of revenue due to their nature. These are called period costs and include things like management salaries, rent, and utilities. These types of expenses are typically recognized as expenses in the period they are associated with. Now, while all expenses are costs to an organization, technically, not all costs are considered expenses. As we talked about earlier, operational costs that a company incurs as part of doing business are considered expenses. However, when a business makes an investment in resources that they plan to use over the long term, this is considered an asset at the time of purchase instead of an expense. For example, if the watch company from earlier purchases a delivery truck for $30,000, this would not be recorded as an expense in their income statement, but instead would show up on their balance sheet as an asset that the company owns. Now, this leads us into the next question, which is very important to consider. How do we determine whether an expenditure results in an asset or an expense? Recognizing an expenditure as an asset means the company can potentially avoid a large expense on their income statement in that period. For this reason, there's accounting standards in place that lay out a set of criteria that need to be met in order to do so. Ultimately, we need to be able to show that the purchase results in a resource for the company that they're in control over and will likely bring future economic benefit. In the example of the delivery truck from earlier, this would meet that criteria since the company owns the delivery truck and they control its use. They also plan to use it in their business over the foreseeable future in order to generate revenue from the sale of their products. This allows them to record the $30,000 as an asset instead of an expense. However, what if the company decided to rent the vehicle from a rental company instead of purchasing it themselves? Since they no longer have ownership over the vehicle, they're not in full control of its use. Like we talked about, one of the key criteria of an asset is being able to control its use. The rental company who owns it could decide to cancel the rental agreement under certain circumstances or even sell off the vehicle without the company's consent. As a result, the monthly payment that the company is making to rent the vehicle would be considered an expense to the company on their income statement instead of an asset. Another example would be if a company decided to rent a building. This would result in a monthly rental expense and not an asset for the organization since they don't have legal ownership over the building. And that brings us to the end of the video. It's nearly impossible for companies to operate without incurring expenses in some shape or form. Whether it's paying employees' salaries, the monthly rent, or purchasing operating supplies, companies generally have to manage a variety of expenses during the regular course of business. For that reason, it's very important that we understand how to account for these expenses in the financial statements, as it can literally mean the difference between showing a profit or loss in that period. If you're interested in learning more about financial accounting concepts like this, please check out our additional videos on Chegg for many more related topics.